fourth. I did it. I finally did it. I was stuck on the jaw and trying to get that right for a while. I had to switch off of balsa screws because they were... It doesn't matter. I finished him. He's really here. Mortimer Handy. And he's perfect. He's just like I imagined him. I just... Forgive me, I just can't believe he's here. There's a convention in Austin and everyone's gonna be there. Gordy, the Muppet people, everybody. I think I might bring him, give him his first public showing. And that shrew Margaret Hampton who told me I was using too many articulated joints and the wood I was sourcing was too expensive, she's gonna eat crow like she's never eaten crow before in her life. I got a letter from Dad today. No, I don't want to talk about that right now. This is... Dr. Martin says I have to focus on the positive when good things happen, and finishing Mortimer is a good thing. There's never been a puppet in the world like this. When people see him, they're not going to believe their eyes. I've got to figure out what he sounds like. I've got to figure out his personality. This is the beginning of beautiful, wonderful things. I just know it. You're not going to believe this. I just got back from Austin. The Muppet people, Henson and his right-hand guy, they could not stop looking at Mortimer. They were asking all these questions about him, and they wanted more details, and they started talking about, well, maybe we fly you over to our studio for a week. But it got so much better. Some network people saw Henson talking to me, and the next thing I know, they won't leave me alone. They're talking about giving me and Mortimer our own show. We're flying out to Los Angeles in a few days. I gotta get an agent. I gotta learn to write scripts. I have so much to do, but I'm so excited I can't even sit down to do it. I can't sleep. I can barely eat. I called Dad, by the way. I know. But I had to tell him. Even he, Mr. High and Mighty, Mr. Quaker, had to admit it was... What were the words he used? He said it was quite the boon. Quite the boon. A month ago, he was writing letters about how I needed to stop all this childishness. And now he's talking about boons? He's hating this being this wrong, which makes it even better. Merry, merry Christmas, children. Ho, ho, ho. I'm alone. No, that's not true. Morty's here, aren't you? You're my little buddy. You're my little... Ho! Whoa. Ted called again a few days ago to tell me how sorry he was that it didn't work out. He said, what did he say? He said, don't feel bad. Lots of pilots never get on the air. It's part of the business. Part of the business. You hear that? It's all just part of the business, Morty. It's part of the business. Did you get that, Mortimer? Stop crying! Nobody likes a crybaby, Mortimer! Nobody likes a... God, I think I cut my hand. Well, I just got back. Sorry, April 10th, 1981. Anyway, I just got back. It was fine. Her name was Alice. She wants to be an interior decorator. I didn't like her hair. We went to an Italian place. Dad thinks she'd be a good stabilizing force for me. Those were his words. There's nothing wrong with her. I don't know what I'm supposed to feel when I'm with someone. Whatever it is, I don't feel it. What? No, you're right. That's true. I didn't think of that. No, come on. You don't mean that. Be nice, okay? Be nice. How did I not think of this? An ensemble. You need an ensemble. That was the problem. There's nobody to play off of. Morty can't just be up there by himself. He needs a partner. Maybe two partners. Maybe it's a family. And he's the patriarch, the father figure, the glue that holds it all together. How did I not think of that? I mean, as soon as Mortimer said it, it was so obvious. Not that he, sorry. I don't mean Mortimer said it. I just... Sometimes I practice Mortimer's voice and we have conversations. It's not anything weird. To be honest, it helps. I don't leave my workshop that often, so I don't see a lot of people. I accidentally went for a month without speaking one time. This was back when I was finishing up Mortimer. I didn't even know a month had gone by. I was just consumed. Then one day I called a Chinese place. I was just trying to order delivery, and I couldn't talk. My throat wouldn't open. It's like an atrophy. So yeah, I talked to Mortimer. Just a way of staying grounded, that's all. Oh, damn it. Sorry. It's August 10th, 1981. January 2nd, 1983. Okay. I think I have the final ensemble. It's Mortimer, the boss. Then you have like a second in command. That's Riley Ruckus. She's a scientist and she always wants more data. Then she has like a brother who's a rival because he's the complete opposite. He's very artistic and pretentious. That's Nick Nack. And then we need kind of a mother hen figure, someone who can take care of everyone. I'm gonna call her Daisy. I think that's it. I think 4 feels like the right number. I'm gonna start building them. Riley first. No, I don't want to talk about that. Because I don't. Okay, fine. Dad came by the workshop. He cut me one more check for the next 2 months and said that's it. No, don't worry, he's lying. He says that all the time, then the checks come in the mail anyway. He's just trying to buy his way out of feeling bad. I don't care how much he goes on about Jesus and society and friends now. I remember the dad I grew up with, and so does he. I didn't have a childhood. I never had toys. Maybe that's why I'm obsessed with them now. Never got a Christmas present, not once. I sat in the dark and hoped he'd pass out before he remembered where he put his belt. You know why he really writes those checks? So he doesn't have to apologize. I'm sorry. Never heard those two words come out of that man's mouth. Never. He thinks he can throw money at me until I'm so far in his debt that he won't have to say sorry anymore. Cow with him. I'll take his money, but I don't have to forgive him. November 8th, 1984. The most amazing news. We just got a call from our new agent, and the network loved the ensemble idea. We're gonna call it Mortimer's Handyman. It'll be like a talk show where we have guests come on. Kids, of course. It is a kid show, and we help them solve problems. We were just on the phone with Rachel, one of their execs, and she said she thought it was crazy that the last place dumped us without even airing the pilot. We can tell she really gets the vision of the show. We think she's a good person. We think she'll really help us. November 10th, 1984. Dr. Martin said he thought it was odd that I'd started saying we a lot on the tapes. He was really, he seemed very concerned about that. He said that I was using the puppets to project, what was it? Right, thank you, Riley. He said I was using them as dissociative agents, that I was fragmenting my personality into them. He actually, you won't believe this, he said he didn't think it was a good idea for me to be making the show. He said the puppets were becoming emotionally unhealthy for me, and spending time around them was disconnecting me from reality. I mean, if he thinks I'm just gonna pass on the second chance to live my dream, all because he thinks whatever he thinks, he's crazy. The show is happening. And this time it's gonna be right. I was too meek the first time around. Anytime anyone told me they thought I should do something, I just nodded and said, sure, whatever you say. I was just happy to be there. Well, now I know better. Now I know that everyone's just trying to screw you and dilute your vision. Most people, they just punch a clock. They don't care if what you're making sucks as long as they get to go home and have a beer and watch The Tonight Show. It doesn't matter to them, but it matters to me. This show is everything to me. Everything. It's gonna be perfect. This time, it's gonna get on the air, and my father is gonna be sitting in his stupid little easy chair, eating one of his frozen dinners, and bang! His son's puppets are gonna be in his face, laughing at him, laughing in his face! I can't wait for that phone call. I cannot wait. Henrietta's gone. I fired her. Her voice is too nasal, too shrill, and she just would not put the emphasis on the words I told her to. And then Rachel called me and about blew a gasket, and I think she's starting not to like me. And I swear to God, how can none of these people do their jobs? If I could just do every puppet myself, if I had 5 arms, or if there were 4 clones of me, I could do it perfectly. It's not that hard. Sometimes I even do the line out loud and say, do it exactly like that. But of course their precious little egos hate that. They get all upset, tell me I'm micromanaging. So I say, fine. And I redub the line with my voice when it goes to air, and they get upset about that too. You can't make these people happy. You can't win. But I'm not bending. Not again. Not this time. This time the show is going to be the way I want it to be. You know what I keep thinking? It's the craziest thing. Mortimer said something to me last night. He said, why don't you just have us do it? Have the handyman puppet themselves. I thought he was kidding, but he was dead serious. He didn't laugh. It's insane. It's crazy. I was just low on sleep and stressed out, but I can't stop thinking about it. What if there was a way? What if there was a way?